Part of the transformation has to come from, you know, a political mobilization. There's no way that you can have a rational argument with white supremacy structures about the provinciality of the structures of knowledge that they are carrying on. It has to be a process of a political struggle to transform that, okay? But then the next thing is that we also need to call things the way they are. For example, if you still call the university, you're still falling into the traps of the cultural genocide, you know, of the epistemicide, because you still are naming that structure as if it was a neutral space. We have to call it the way what it is, westernized university. You see, if the structures of knowledge are only white males of five countries, then we have to call it this epistemic racism / sexism. So we need to call by their name this thing. And in terms of what is happening in Britain today, I think that with PREVENT, because PREVENT is surveilling Muslim bodies inside educational institutions, but it's also surveilling the content of education. This is a fundamental aspect of PREVENT. So we are kind of back to the obscurantist times, where now the scholarship produced by people who happen to be from other epistemologies, other spirituality, are completely banned from the conversation. Otherwise, you'd be accused of terrorism. So we need to name things. What is that? Eurocentrism? That's Eurocentric fundamentalism. When you only have the authority of knowledge of white males of five countries as the only source of knowledge for science, history, philosophy, social theory, whatever, it's a form of fundamentalism. Why don't we call it Eurocentric fundamentalism? Why don't we call this banning of other, of the epistemic diversity of the world, epistemic terrorism or intellectual terrorism? Because right now, all this wording is thrown against you. You see? And in a sense, put you in a defensive mode because you try to prove you say, no, I'm not a terrorist. No, I'm not a fundamentalist. No, but you are proving, trying to prove that to a Eurocentric fundamentalism that is calling you fundamentalist. You see the point? Or to structures of knowledge that are intellectually terrorist, accusing you of being terrorist. And so, how are you going to really, that's a lost battle if you go into the terrain, accept the premises of the accusation, you just come in to defend yourself, to say, oh, I'm not a terrorist, oh, I'm not this, I'm not that. You know, in fact, given the way the structures of knowledge are placed, you're always going to be on the subaltern side, and you're always going to be suspicious of terrorism or fundamentalism, whatever. And especially when you have institutional racism already put in place by the state to surveil Muslims, both in the context of education as well as Muslim bodies. So the way out to this, I think, is political mobilization struggle and change the language. Let's invert the language. Let's show how terrorists and how fundamentalists are the structures of knowledge of the educational system here.